Listen, get ready to embark on a journey to wellness with our incredible sponsor, Organifi. I want you to imagine a life where your health is not just a priority, but it's a celebration of vitality. Organifi brings you the magic, a symphony of superfoods designed to transform your daily routine into a celebration of well-being. In the chaos of life, self-care often takes a back seat. But what if I told you that taking care of yourself could be as simple as sipping something extraordinary? Enter Organifi, where health meets taste and every sip is a step toward a healthier, happier you. From the refreshing green juice to the soothing gold tea, Organifi's product line is a treasure trove of superfood goodness. No artificial ingredients, no added sugars, just pure organic bliss because your body deserves the best. Organifi is a commitment to clean, conscious living. It's a call to action, an invitation to take your health seriously and make every day a success. And here's the exciting news. From November 20th to November 27th, Organifi is offering these exclusive deals. You spend $100, you get 20% off plus free shipping. If you spend $150, you get 20% off, free shipping, and you receive some additional products. Digest, Turmeric Plus, and Focus. And for Black Friday only, enjoy 20% off and free shipping with no minimum threshold. But that's not all, guys. For Giving Tuesday on the 28th, Organifi has a special treat. You can get free shipping on the red juice packets, the 30-count packets. And get this, Organifi is going to do a double donation to Vitamin Angels for the red juice sales that day, guys. So you're supporting a great cause as well. Ready to say yes to a healthier you and make a difference in the world? Visit Organifi.com/success and save big on your order. Plus, don't miss the exclusive Black Friday and Giving Tuesday deals. Your health journey begins now. Join the movement toward a thriving, vibrant you with Organifi. Her coach had her training nonstop, rain, snow, whatever. It's like, yo, track meets happen in this weather. When everybody else stopping, you're training. And the homegirl was just like, all right, you the coach, I'm going to follow. But it just shows you when you get that mentality, bro, the results are going to show.
Yeah, and again, like I said with Maul, I want to go in the other direction and just challenge those of you who are winning and who stop and do something different.
You are winning. So it's that's like, a whole other thing, though. Yeah. People don't know when they're winning and when they're not winning. I'm just being real.
You ready?
What's going on, world? Welcome to another edition of the Secret to Success podcast. I'm your host, CJ, joined as always by the Bayesian sensation, Mr. Carl Wesley Phillips.
What's going on, y'all? What it do?
I got your twin brother in here.
Come on.
Y'all matching.
Come on.
Hold on. Got some new shoes for Thanksgiving.
Come on, bro. Come on, man.
Hey.
My wife.
Shout out to Camille, bro.
Told me that my last George she bought me looked dingy. And she said she can't have me out here looking bad. So she went and she know the colors. She know the 9-to-5 scheme.
You feel me?
Come on. Nah, that's fire.
Branding. That's what that is.
Mm. He who finds a what?
A wife.
Finds a what?
Come on, good a thing. Good thing.
And finds what?
Come on, favor of the Lord.
Favor in the Lord.
Don't quiz me on the scripture. In front of everybody. Okay, I'm just saying. I said I'd be a mess up.
When we was in
the GED wasn't in Bible study.
When we was in the DR,
yeah.
Bro, I kept on looking to my, and I was saying the script. You weren't there.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I know. About the DR. About that resort. Yeah, talk about that later. No. Well, I'm going to tell you where to go so I can be there next year.
Oh, listen. How's everybody Thanksgiving, man?
Oh, man.
Unexpectedly great. I had an unexpected. So let me just tell you what happened. So unfortunately, man, it's like a 30-year run, man. COVID messed up my wife's family's run. I had a 30-year run at her aunt's crib in the basement. Yep. And when COVID hit, the aunties are some of them are a little older.
Yeah.
So they pulled back. And once they pulled back, then the matriarch of the family just passed. The sister that was like the matriarch of them all, she just passed. Mm. And I say that, you know, with due respect, because I'm sure some of the other ones like, well, we the matriarch. You know what I'm saying? We were the one. But anyway, she passed. And so I'm just being real. Like it's like, you know, Big Mama passed. Sometimes you break up from the big boy, and then you had the small families are not getting together. So Diddy was like,
Now you and Diddy, Big Mama and Big Papa.
Big Papa, yeah, they took over. I can't call me Big Papa. Yeah.
And so what happened was, it was like, okay, that happened. So we was trying to figure out what we was gonna do.
Yeah.
And then I got a gig in Hawaii.
Yeah.
So I was like, bro, I'm not about to go to Hawaii and then fly all the way back.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Like fly back to the States, then fly to Detroit. I was like, that's too much. So I was like, we'll go to Hawaii. And then we'll just come back. And Diddy was like, well, I'm so used to the big family. Let me call C and we'll go to his house for Thanksgiving. We'll see what he's doing. So some kind of way, C called D calling C and going over to their crib, turning it up.
No.
We coming to your crib.
No. We're doing it. We're going to do it out there.
You know what I'm saying? The whole flip boy. It was flip mode.
Yeah.
So then C and they end up coming in some kind of way. I don't know what happened, but C must have told Tobe just in passing.
You know, like, that's my son. He going to follow me wherever I go.
So I just was like, yo, he was like, C must have said, yo, Tobe, we going to whatever. And so Tobe was like, well, then we going to. And I was like, okay, okay. I got to get a catering service because we ain't, we coming in, we leaving Hawaii. We going to get there to Tuesday night. Yeah. So Wednesday, we ain't about, we just don't. So we found somewhere. Shout out to my boy, AJ, CP3, little cousin, who is always on the lookout for your boy, me and Jalen. So he's like, don't worry about it. I got you, Harold and Bells looked out for us, catered the whole thing. In LA, C picked it up from me, brought it to the crib, put it in the refrigerator, and it was phenomenal, man. So yeah, we had an unexpected guest. Somebody asked me, E, how refreshing? I said, was it refreshing?
No.
It wasn't refreshing, but we had a blast.
A blast.
But refreshing is not what it was.
Yeah.
We had four babies under four. Yeah. See, that's not refreshing.
Listen, I have never, and them my godchildren, love them to life, but I've never been so happy I had a vasectomy. I'm going to got another one.
All right.
I take two.
Back to back.
Bruh, I almost got another one just like, this a lot.
I think it's just because we older now, right? Like when we was young, fact. Remember we was in your 20s?
Yeah.
You know.
Before. I don't know if I've ever done four.
Not four days.
Under four.
Yeah.
That's different.
No, they got they got it.
And they all know what they want.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, we had a blast, though.
Oh, we had a blast. Yeah.
But it was work.
But it was hilarious because Lil Choo Choo was trying to get something to Diddy. She said, take it to Pawpaw. Talking about E. So we was calling E Pawpaw.
That's the name she gave me over Thanksgiving. I said, what? What? How do we go from
Uncle
E to
Pawpaw? Bro, they was calling E Pawpaw. I was like, oh, this is hilarious,
bro. The grown folk were.
Hey, come on. But no, man, let me tell you something. We got out to San Diego. We went to L.A. for a minute because he was in Hawaii, so we went to L.A. Shout out to Sean. Stopped by Sean Steele.
Oh, you stopped by Sean?
Yeah, I did, yeah. We surprised him. His son, I told Jordan, I was like, yeah, we coming to L.A. We'll stop by and see how. He was like, we having a Friendsgiving. Y'all should come by on Saturday. So it just worked out timing-wise perfect. So Sean didn't even know I was coming.
Nice.
And then we popped up. He was like, man, what you doing here? So that was dope, man. And then the family, we kicked it in Santa Monica. And just had a good time. That was my kids. Well, Trey had been to L.A. once, I think, when he was little. But took them out there. We did the whole, I'm talking about Hollywood, Ripley's Believe It or Not. You know what I'm saying? We did the whole.
Money.
Yeah, we did the whole nine. And then went to San Diego, of course. You know what I'm saying? To kick it in the mansion.
In the mansion.
It was with the pool outside, fully done.
Tobe said it best, the ETA cribs.
ETA cribs.
I love it.
That sucker was.
This is the house that ETA built.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I got to cook a little bit. I got to use the outdoor
Which
grill.
Which one?
California.
This one? That
California.
One. These two?
Hey.
These two?
And with
two.
Your testimony.
Yeah. Come on.
The Lord just keep blessing me.
You feel me?
Hey, bro.
But yeah, no, it was dope, man. We had a fantastic time. Carl?
Oh, bro, I had the refreshing time.
Good.
I had it for all of us. No, you get Tamisha's mom just left. Yeah. So my parents back in Barb. So it's just us. Yeah. So I played Mario Kart. I'm talking about we just chill, just played with the kids, just hung out, relaxed. So this one was that relaxing one for us, man. Just the four of us just chilled. So just low key.
Did you have turkey? Did anybody?
We just did a little chicken. It was just the four of us. So we took a little chicken and did our little barbecue boy with it.
Okay. I'm not mad. Barbecue chicken on Thanksgiving. That's
I ain't cooked.
We just switched it up.
Yeah, nah.
You know, the Kings threw down.
Yeah. Who cooked?
Everybody.
Really?
Everybody.
Potlucks.
Yeah, so we, yeah.
What Tommy make?
Nothing.
Oh. Yeah. Tommy brought the everybody good. Tommy brought the paper plates and the juice and the pop.
Okay,
somebody got to do that.
Nope, Tommy did bring the caramel cake.
Okay, he brought the caramel cake.
Yeah, he brought the caramel cake. Yeah.
From?
From
Not Harold's?
No, not Harold's. Okay. No, they only get the Slice Boys.
Okay.
What's my girl name, man? She actually know you. I want to talk about some sweets.
From her?
It's not, ain't she sweet?
Sugar.
Come on, man. Yeah. What is
it? I've been there with you, but it's sugar.
It's in Chicago.
Wow, it's sugar. Is it called?
Where is it at?
Sugar or something? It's in Chicago.
Man, I'm going to have to. Oh, man, she's going to kill me. Oh,
man. You messed up her
We'll get it by the end of the show.
And, yeah, wow.
And then we got Scorchon to edit it out.
You know, there we go. We're going to have to do that. But yeah, no, we everybody pitched in, man. You know, even as far away as Michigan, Lansing. Pops brought the dressing.
Oh,
bro. You know what I'm saying? He gave us.
That's the only thing we missed.
Yeah.
I ain't want to have Pop ship it to Cali. I don't want to overdo it. Yeah, it's a bit much.
Camille's mom made the turkey. My mom made ham. You know, Camille made greens. And, you know, she make a turkey derby pie. So, you know.
A turkey what?
Derby pie.
Ooh.
What's that?
Oh, yeah. My God.
It's, I don't know. I never heard of that.
Chocolate base.
It's got the chocolate. It's got. It's Kentucky hard to even describe. It's got chocolate chips in it.
Yeah.
But it's like. Ooh. I don't even know what it is. This is a good pie.
Really?
Make sure Camille makes it all the time. Camille makes it every holiday. It's called Kentucky Derby Pie. She makes it every holiday. So, yeah, so, you know, everybody pitched in, man, and it was a great time. We did it at my parents' house, you know, because my dad was there, and a blessing. You know, my dad went back in the hospital just a few days prior, and then they released him actually on Thanksgiving. He came back in. He was doing great, man, and all the family got together, and we all surrounded him. And man, he said the blessing, man, and you know, yeah, it was nice. I told CJ for the first time in 47 years, I'm 46. For the first time in 46 years,
Denzel,
somebody other than my dad cut the turkey and the ham.
Okay, I thought we got a
cutter. It's one of them old school 1980s, as seen on TV type cutters.
Yeah.
And my dad been using since like 1983.
Mm. Wow.
He kind of was like, man, a movie. He was like, son.
Like the golden child. Like,
he said, I think you're ready.
I want the knife.
I was like, I'm not worthy. He handed it to
Please.
The
knife. Yeah. Give me the knife.
I cut the turkey, bro. I cut the turkey and I cut the ham, man. First time, bro. So that's like a tradition in our family.
No question.
Yeah, no.
Praise God for him, bro.
Yeah.
Praise God for him. Don't let me go down that path. Yeah. Praise God for him, bro.
Oh,
praise God.
So, yeah. So, it was great, man. We had Gersh. Gersh was there, man.
Did he touch you?
Huh?
Did he touch you?
He didn't touch me. He didn't lay hands on me, believe it or not. He laid hands on my dad, but he didn't lay hands on me.
Okay.
But, you know, because it wasn't even on that. Gersh was just like, hey, you know, when I was in Texas, he did touch me in Texas now. Yeah. And he was like, hey, man, I'm going to come.
Can we explain who Gersh is for the listeners?
Everybody should know Gersh by now.
I know, but just the way y'all said. What is happening right now?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Once you figure out who he is, you're going to
want to touch. We got some people, this their first episode.
Okay, I'm just saying. Y'all going to want to touch y'all too.
Who's laying hands on all of us.
Our families, everything.
Right. Well, Gersh was like, when we was in Texas, we was in Texas at Toby concert. Gersh was just like, yeah, Maul, he put me to the side and said, yeah, I'm going to come to Chicago. And he's like, man, after the holiday, though.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm going to let your family, you know, you guys be together. And I said, what you doing? I said, you going to be spend time with family? He said, yeah, I usually go to Boston Market and just get a meal.
Yeah.
From Boston Market.
Praise God.
Yeah. And I said,
that sounds smooth to me.
Hey, Gersh played him. He was like, I probably just, you know,
get a peanut butter and jelly.
And just look out the window.
Oh, bro.
Wishing I had some turkey.
Meanwhile, his mom cooking and everything.
Yeah, Gersh.
Bro, I was like, why don't you come on to Chicago, man? You know, I said, why don't you come a little early, a couple days early, spend some time with us and our family. And Gersh was like, really? I'm like, Gersh, you family, bro. Gersh came, man, stayed in my house, and great time.
Yeah, he showed me he was in the Quinny Suites.
No, he was in the Quinny Suite. First person. You got tripped off on Gersh, man.
Whoa.
Oh, he don't got no
black there to play. Wait a minute.
Yeah. That's supposed to be a secret, dog.
Wait.
Oh, come on, now. You got
a secret.
No, it's spoiled.
It's a guest.
He's the first person to sleep in that room.
Oh, he got it.
Wait.
He ain't there. Can't nobody be there.
That's the rules. That's the rules.
I'm coming to Chicago.
Oh, yes.
You don't put Gersh in the other guest room?
Right? Nah, bro. Nah.
At least I need to sign off on it.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Yeah, bro.
It's a different podcast.
Well, we thought because it was Gersh to see it be okay.
I thought so, personally.
Personally, he did a lot of personal stuff
with CJ.
So I just
stay in the quarters downstairs. It's like, come on.
So man, if I come to San Diego, I can sleep in your bed?
Yeah, if I'm not there.
In your bed?
If I'm not there.
Hey, y'all know y'all two on bed stories. Let's not do this no more.
Right, he'd already borrowed a mattress.
Let's not do this no more.
He can't borrow a mattress. When he didn't borrow, Gersh can't borrow a mattress. But he can.
Yeah. I'll be right at E-Bed.
Yeah. Hey, yes, just let me know when you coming. I can put the plastic down.
It is that time of year. Hey, we got to bring it out. Yeah. Y'all know the grown man gifts. Shout out my man. What's my man name again? Carl, get his name.
We got it added. Yeah.
But anyway. Everybody had a good thing. Mo, how was we saw the Lions and the Bears play. That was pretty.
How you say Lions first? B come before L.
Hmm. And sometimes why?
Well, y'all took that. Marl was all ready at the house. Yeah. He had his memes ready.
Oh, I am ready.
We got one more, Marl.
We got one more, but this one though.
Yeah.
You know, we had
everything could change.
We had them on the hook. Yeah. The Lions are who we thought they were.
Oh, they were.
If you want to crown that, go crown. They were exactly who we thought they were. We had them to the last. I'm talking about the last minute and some seconds.
Literally.
Run. We let them go. We started playing to lose.
Yeah. Man.
That's it. We was just like.
Bro, don't get me on that, bro.
Oh, bro.
I'm watching Alabama and Auburn.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about.
Bro, I'm just saying.
No, that's what I want to talk about.
Why we going to prevent. You've been rushing my man all game, and now we don't rush
him. You only got two people out there rushing
him. Bro, ain't nobody – and you just going to let him just have all the time in the world? I'm just like, bro, I'm not trying to be disrespectful. I'm just talking about life.
Yeah, yeah.
We just be switching up, bro. Yeah, it's just like – it don't make sense.
No, for real, I wanted – and y'all can stay there, but that's kind of what I wanted to talk about because me and Ma was talking about it in the car, and I was like, yo, think about this. And this is, you know, just using Auburn here as a, you know, microcosm for life, right? Think about this. Auburn lost to New Mexico State, I believe, 31-10.
Yeah. Mm.
But had Georgia beat
and
Alabama beat both to the last second.
Yep.
Carl, think about this. Bama and Georgia might be the top two, three, four best teams in the country. Shout out to all my friends that are Michigan fans. I can hear y'all yelling at me right now. Cool, whatever. Y'all good too. But we talking about
elite.
You got Georgia, who the best? I don't care. They ain't lost, so they still the best. And Bama, and you went to the Georgia game. They had Georgia done.
Whole game.
Whole game. And this ain't even about getting came back on.
No.
Got Bama done until the last second.
Done.
But lost to New Mexico State 31-10.
Yep.
So what'd that tell you? I'm saying, yo, it's crazy how same team, when you locked in, what a difference being locked in make. And so, E, I guess you could start it off because I'm like, you're one of those people who could self-generate that energy, but it's something about like knowing we got Bama coming in and you rise to the occasion. Like, boom, you playing like to the level of your competition. And then you play somebody and it's like, yo, that's humans, right? Like, you can't bring it like that. You might have a good day. You could have a good week. You can't bring it every single game like that. And I think it's crazy when you think about the fact that this team now done had two of the best teams in the country on the ropes, but then you lost five other games. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, yo, how does that happen? Yeah. You, if anything, them should have been your only two losses.
Right.
But it's hard to bring that energy all the time.
So that's the problem, I think, people bringing energy. Like, I think that's the problem.
Mm.
So I was talking to one of my homies, kind of how I got to Hawaii. And, man, they're a beast, bro. Like, I'm not going to say everything about them because then I kind of be, like, giving it away. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just going to say they're a beast. And so we was just talking, like, you know, this was the Jordan year.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So Cass was kind of like, this was the Jordan year. So he was like, yo, next year is the year 24. And I was like, well, it's still the Jordan year, but it's Kobe, but it's still it's still the Jordan year. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, but he was like, you know, kind of breaking it down for me. And so he's like, yo, the Jordan year is the Mamba mentality. Mm. You know, so we was, you know, whatever. I'm feeling it. I'm like, okay, yeah, I got it. You know, whatever. So then he talking to me like, yo, E, like, I'm killing it here. I'm killing it here. I'm killing it here. I'm killing it here. But, like, relationships, I ain't never been able to kill it in, you know, like, being in the long term or being in a healthy relationship, I'm not really. Like, E, what you think is wrong? I was like, you just said it. You just named three, four areas that you killing it because you got a mentality. It's the Mamba mentality.
Yeah, it's the Mamba
mentality, bro. You're not even hearing what you're saying. You saying the 24 is the year of the Mamba mentality. I said, let's take Mamba out. Mamba is just a adjective to describe the type of mentality. Yeah. I said, but it's a mentality. Yeah. I said, the problem is you don't have a mentality in marriage. You don't have a mentality for marriage.
Okay.
So that's why you're not sweet in it, because you don't have a mentality. But you're killing it in the business because you have a business mentality. I said, I just noticed that people who don't kill it, it just, they don't have a mentality. They have energy. So energy come and go. It come and go. So it's like one day you on fire, next day you in a funk. Why? Because you relied on energy. Kobe wasn't relying on energy. Kobe was had a mentality. And so when you have a mentality, it doesn't really matter, whatever. So I was like, yo, that's the missing piece. Y'all get hype when y'all play Alabama. Y'all get hype when y'all play Georgia. When you're playing somebody else, you don't have the energy because you don't see why you should be doing it. Like, they don't, like New Mexico, that don't get you up. That don't get you pumped up. But I'm watching when you play other teams, you shift, but Bama still got to play. Like, bro, I literally saw Nick Saban going off before the fourth down. Like, I was tripping, like, he acting like they got a chance to win. Like, bro, I was looking like, bro, my man act like they got a chance to win. I'm like, how did you miss a fair catch? It's a fair catch. How did you miss it? You missed it because you were in the moment. You weren't in the mentality. If you was in the mentality, you would have just routinely caught that boy. But you was in a moment. Like, okay, this is a big kick. It's not a big kick. It's not a big catch. It's a routine.
It's catch another
you
kick.
One you done did 100 times in practice.
You've done it 100 times, and you could do it 100 times here. But now you're doing it 100 times with the stadium pack. Now you're doing it with 100 times with the Alabama could possibly, I could fumble, and Alabama could, everything you just thought of, you brought it into reality. And then you were scared because you knew it always happens. When you fumble right there, they score right there.
Always
score.
Always, bro.
And your boys on the side saying it's going to be all right. It's not going to be all right. It's not. This is Alabama. They got the ball.
And then
30.
They snapped it, and the snap got messed up, and they really was like, you good. Like, they just lost like an extra 15. Remember they snapped it?
And it went back.
And so they're like, I told you good. So for me, it's, if I can say it in 10 seconds, energy versus mentality. And generally, the people who don't have a mentality in something don't do as well.
Okay, yeah,
or don't
but we gotta. Now you just stumbled upon something, but that's we gotta unpack that.
How much do you think you're paying a month on subscriptions? That's what I thought. Most people think they're paying $80 a month, but they're actually paying closer to $200. And that's why I rock with Rocket Money. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions, monitors your spending, and helps you lower your bills, all in one place. With Rocket Money, you can easily cancel the ones you don't want with just the press of a button. No more long hold times or annoying emails with customer service. Rocket Money does all the work for you. Rocket Money can even negotiate to lower your bills by up to 20%. All you have to do is take a picture of your bill and Rocket Money takes care of the rest. Rocket Money also lets you monitor all your expenses in one place. It recommends custom budgets based on your past spending, and they'll even send you notifications when you've reached your spending limits. With over 5 million users and counting, Rocket Money has helped save its customers an average of $720 a year and $1 billion in total savings so far. Stop wasting money on things you don't use. Cancel your unwanted subscriptions and manage your money the easy way by going to rocketmoney.com/S2S. Again, that's rocketmoney.com/S2S. rocketmoney.com/S2S. This one is for all my holiday shoppers out there. As we dive into the season of giving, let's talk about these everyday purchases we make. The little gifts, the fun snacks, you name it. But what about giving yourself a little something extra this year? How about the gift of building your credit history with Chime Secured Credit Builder Visa Credit Card? Imagine no annual fees, no interest, and no credit check to get you started. Yep, you heard it right. It's the season to treat yourself, and Chime's got your back. You can use it everywhere Visa credit cards are accepted, and the best part? You're building credit using your own money. It's like a win-win for your wallet and for your credit score. And it's not just about credit cards. Chime's checking account is a game changer too. Get paid up to 2 days earlier with a qualifying direct deposit. Enjoy fee-free overdraft with SpotMe and say goodbye to monthly fees because Chime has none. Access to 60,000 plus fee-free ATMs, more than the top three national banks combined. Sending and receiving money is a breeze with no fees attached. Plus, with SpotMe, Chime has your back in case you overspend. Overdraft up to $200 without fees when you set up a qualifying direct deposit. It's like having a financial safety net. So here's the deal. Build your credit this holiday season. Just open a Chime checking account with a $200 qualified direct deposit to get started. You can get started at Chime.com, that's Chime.com/success. Again, that's Chime.com/success. The Chime Credit Builder Visa credit card is issued by Stride Bank and a member of the FDIC. Out-of-network ATM withdrawal fees may apply. Call 1-844-244-6363 for more details. Late payments may negatively impact your credit score. Results may vary. Early access to direct deposit funds depends on payer SpotMe eligibility requirements, and overdraft limits do apply.
Energy versus mentality, because I don't think, in a sense, I don't know if I fully follow you in terms of the difference between the two. Yeah. Okay, mentality, energy. Because I feel like if I'm bringing energy to the situation, that is a mentality, right? Like you thinking like, oh, okay, I'm coming into this thing with energy.
It can't be.
So is mentality, or are you saying it's energy plus strategy?
No, I'm saying mentality is a way of life. It's a philosophical belief. You don't cut it on and cut it off. It don't go. MJ don't cut. Like, this is the thing I love about MJ. And again, I could be biased.
Yeah.
But the thing I love about
you
MJ.
Are.
The thing I love about MJ, for real, I'm not saying he won every game. I'm saying that MJ was the same player all the time. Period.
Yeah.
I'm not saying he won every game. And that's what people be hearing. I'm not saying that. I'm telling you, MJ didn't care if he was playing the wackest team. He didn't care if he was playing the best team. He brought the same person to every single. He didn't go, oh, it's the Pistons. I'm about to play hard. He going, okay, Cleveland ain't as good as the Pistons, so they ain't going to come at me the way they going to come at me. So I got to make up something.
Yeah.
I got to tell myself that my man just said something about my mama, and I got to get pissed now and go, what you say about my mama?
The water boy.
That's it.
Oh,
that's,
water that's boy.
You know your mama.
That's all I said. My mama. Oh, you talking about my mama? So I'm just saying. But you see
Bobby
other players who are good and maybe even great, you can honestly say, yo, depending on who they playing, sometimes they may bring their A game 80% of time, 90% of time. Bro, Jordan brought the same game every single time he played. He tried to take you out, sweep you, take you out in four. That was just his mentality. Same thing with Kobe. You can say whatever you want to say. Yeah, he took 50 shots all the time. It didn't matter.
Consistent.
He was consistently, like, bringing it. And so I think when you do energy, the challenge with energy is – when you bring the energy, there are outside forces sometimes that drains the energy. You feel me? It just is life, bro. It's just like, so say you're an energy person, but you about to go hoop. You know, you got a game against somebody and somebody you close to died, or you got into it with your girl. Sometimes, bro, people with energy, they get into it with their girl, and she kind of, that whole little thing that just happened, it drained you.
Yeah.
Or you got into an argument with your other player, and then you went out and you could tell, because I coach players. And I'd be like, bro, how'd you put up that many points? And then tomorrow you put up five, like, or you put up zero. Like, what happened? What were you thinking? And well, true story, I can't say what happened, but somebody told me something crazy that happened to him before the game. I was like, bro, you put up 20 and then you put up zero. It's like, I ain't trying to be funny, but this happened to me before. I was like, oh, that's scary. Oh, yeah, I could see why. Bro, I guarantee you the same thing happened to Michael Jordan or Kobe. I guarantee you they would have blocked that out. Even though it was real what they were saying. It was a real challenge. Yep. It was a real problem.
Yep.
I know Mike would have just been like, yo, it happened, it happened. I got to play the game. So I'm saying to you, as an energy person, there are times when energy works, but there are times when you're matching your energy with another person's energy. But when you have a mentality, that is, so let me give you an example. So even today, you know, we had our, you know, whatever. Moni had a baby shower. I told my wife, you know, 1 o'clock, you need to drop some stuff off. Cool, I got you. I end up getting a call, bro. Jada was like, Dad, Moni just called. They need the truck because we got to put some stuff in there. I promise y'all, I don't care what's going on. I told C, which I hate to disappoint. There's only one person I'm going to disappoint him over, and that's Dee Dee. And I just was like, yo, I got to go take Didi to do what I got to do. Like, it's a mentality, Ma. Like, it's not, I got to test and see which one is more important. It's like, bro, if Didi need me to do something, I got to stop what I'm doing and doing it. Now, I'm not saying that's, I'm not saying every man should do everything with his wife. I'm not saying that. I'm telling you that's my mentality. Once the kids left the house and it's just the two of us and we empty nesters, I'm not about to have Didi going to do anything on the solo, especially carrying stuff, driving stuff, dropping stuff off. I'm like, I'm good.
Oh, for sure.
So then I'm like,
because you know she'll do it.
She will.
Oh, for sure.
And I'm not saying this to be disrespectful, but when I got there to do it, it was no men there outside of Chuck to help. So that he had a 300-pound, like they doing, I guess, ice cream cones or something, softies. So, bro, I was like, bro, I'm there. I'm not saying that a man is wrong because he sent his wife to go do a baby shower. I'm just saying my mentality, not my energy.
Yeah.
My energy is, D, I ain't feel like going with you today. Right, I'm not going to go help you today. No, I feel in my marriage what works is for us to do everything together. Unless there's some emergency. Another man may not feel like that. He entitled to his own. But what works for my family, kids are gone. I don't travel without you if I don't have to. Like, it's got to be an emergency.
Yeah.
Like, we by ourselves. You ain't got kids at the crib to entertain you when I'm gone or nothing to do. Get on a plane. Let's go. That's my mentality. So it was funny. Candace said it. Here's how you know it's a mentality. Somebody said something about Didi ain't going. Like, Didi may not go, and Candace was like, oh, no, you got to twist it. If Didi don't go, it's not just Didi don't go. No, Eric ain't coming if Didi ain't going. Even Candace knew in the conversation. Like, if you can't get Didi to go, to X Eric out. He probably not going if Didi ain't going. You feel me? Unless Didi say, all right, Hawaii. I was like, bro, you're not even paying me enough to go. You giving me a flight, hotel at the Ritz-Carlton for 5 days. A little money, like it ain't bad money, but it ain't my money. And I was like, bro, I can't do it. Didi was overheard the conversation. Where you going? I said, Hawaii. But he ain't paying me, but, and what he doing? First class ticket? Yeah, we going to Hawaii. I'm like, okay, we going to Hawaii then.
Yeah.
But how what? I'm like, I'm going to say that. So I'm just saying the mentality, you don't cut it on and cut it off. It is in your DNA. It's what you eat.
You know what's crazy too? Is as you sit there and say that, it's crazy because when you have that mentality, other people understand that.
Absolutely.
Mentality. So what did I say to you when you said you had to go do what you had to do? I was pissed.
No.
It's so much a part of your mentality that it don't even.
Yeah.
I don't even. But I'm saying, think about it. When it's energy.
Right.
Now it's like, oh, you ain't even cut like that.
Yeah.
Now you messing up. Like, I'm already knowing.
Yeah.
Oh, that's one of them things where you don't even. I just was like, all right, cool. We'll go do Patreon episode. We'll go do something else and just wait for you to get back.
Yeah.
So you understand. When you move like that, you start to create that mentality.
Yeah.
And the mentality starts to take on a life of its own.
Absolutely.
And everybody understands the mentality, acquiesce to that mentality.
Yeah.
So it's like Kobe shooting the last shot. We know that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
hey,
nobody
this.
Got pissed. That I promise you, one person pissed when Kobe took the last shot.
Yeah.
Now, you know.
You already knew.
You already not, now, the first few times you played with him, you might have been like, wait, what's going on? He not going. But after that, you just knew.
And you start passing to him. But
you start passing to him.
I promise you, I never miss a podcast. You flying in, you flying. It's a lot. Not only was it a baby shower, I specifically told you what, Carl?
Oh, that's Moni and Chuck. Bro,
who are givers of all givers.
That's, you can't not,
Bro, I'm like, see, if it was somebody else,
hold on,
I could have been like.
I'm out the loop.
Yeah, I know.
They having a grandbaby.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Grass today. No, they ain't not having a baby.
No.
Okay.
Yeah,
no. All right. Just, but still. I was about to say, man, Chuck.
Yeah, come on.
But I'm saying I told Carl, again, because their mentality.
It's appropriate. It's the season.
It's appropriate. Yeah, it's appropriate.
First night.
Yeah, it's appropriate. But I told C, I said, bro, I promise you, anybody else, I would have told him.
I told Tamisha when we were leaving the house this morning, I'm not sure how we're going to do it, but we're going to do both.
For sure.
Chuck and I'm like, she's not going to trip. See, this Chuck and Moni.
Yeah.
Yeah, we might not do baby showers, but, bro, each one of us, Ma, you probably don't know them as well, but, bro, they were there for us when we.
Period.
Bro, nothing.
When we didn't have the.
Nothing.
We were one property away.
Three or four.
They was the property for us.
Bro,
they were the one. I'm talking about $1,000 checks.
Tamisha used to keep these kids, bro. Now, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So they're family. I was going to say, if I'm going to go back to the actual definition, I got the poster at home, Mamba mentality. Yeah. Like, a constant quest to be the best version of yourself. Mm-hmm. There's no category in that. Mm-hmm. It don't say in sports.
Yeah.
It don't say as an entrepreneur, the best version of yourself. Yeah. So when you think about energy, and I keep hearing that we've defined emotion as energy in motion.
Right.
Whereas when you talk about, I heard values.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
Non-negotiables. Yeah. Those are all the words that are coming to my mind as he's talking. These are non-negotiable. This is not an option.
Yeah.
It's not optional. What's important to me is important to me. Doesn't matter who, you know, what circumstance comes up. So the question is, are you clear on what you value?
Yeah. Mm.
Because, and I, again, this is Carl speaking. I'm at this stage in my life where I'm transparent. I'm old enough now to speak my truth. I valued work over my family.
Mm.
I valued work over God.
Mm.
Like, I'm just being real.
Absolutely,
like,
no question.
I'm not playing with people no more. Like, these are things that I value. Yeah. So, it doesn't, bro, same example. Podcast today, I might not have got up and had worship or nothing, but I was like, oh, I got to get to the podcast.
Absolutely, yeah.
As opposed to, like, Negro, like, you wouldn't thank God for your life this morning. How you going?
Yeah. Wow.
My training says I'm supposed to prioritize God.
Absolutely.
But Carl got up and prioritized the podcast and everything else. Work. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So now I'm just challenging people. Be clear on what you value. Like he said, I ain't mad at it, but understand what you value. And if you're cool with that, cool. If not, now we got to shift some stuff. You might have to upset some people. Like, Maul, let me hit you back. I got to just give me a 10-minute prayer, boy. I got to hit you back. I got to let. See, whatever. Somebody going to have to, like, you got to shift that.
Absolutely.
But you got to be clear on what you prioritize.
Absolutely, bro.
Yeah, part of that mentality too, man. And it go back. Like, when I look at Auburn against Georgia, I was at that game.
Yeah.
When I look at Auburn against Alabama, when I look at the Bears against the Lions, right? It all came down. It wasn't about losing the game. Because if you think about it, dog, losing the game, is the that's the small part.
Yeah.
You've lost at least 100 plays before you lost the game.
Yeah.
And so I think people, even in life, you losing day to day. You losing play by play. When you're talking about the Mamba mentality, right, and you're talking about just that every single day, and that's that go back to them five pillars.
Yeah.
Like every single day, I stay in that. Y'all, you know, you anytime y'all call me, I'm either in the gym.
In the gym.
I'm at a property.
Yeah.
You be like, well, you man, I'm at a property. Or I'm with Camille.
Yeah.
I'm with family.
Oh.
I'm in them five pillars, and I know that, see, that's winning the play.
Yeah.
Mm. Every single day that I'm spending them times in them pillars, I'm winning the play. Each play, which in return helps me win the overall game of life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think people just automatically, they go to winning the game.
Yeah. Mm.
They don't do all the things in the gym, all the free throws that Mike was doing.
Yeah.
That's why Mike can get on the free throw line and close his eyes and shoot, know the ball going in. I just saw a clip, but they showed Dennis Rodman. Whenever Mike gets to shoot a free throw, Dennis would turn his back and walk away.
Hmm.
They got a clip on YouTube where they show Dennis Rodman, like, and he would tell, like, yeah, he gonna make it.
Yeah.
Like, he knew he was gonna make it. Mm. Why? Because Mike was in the gym shooting hundreds and hundreds of free throws. And it's like, dog, some people that's listening to us right now, like, what are you doing every day?
Yeah.
Like, what's your practice?
Because
your mentality comes from the practice.
The practice. That's it.
It comes from the.
That's it.
So I got confidence now. When it got me to, when it's something dealing with me physically, I got confidence knowing that I can accomplish it. Why?
Because
every single day I'm doing that. I'm practicing that.
Yeah.
I got confidence if anything come up with me and my wife, anything come up with family, I got confidence in it. I don't have to now go and practice real quick. You can't practice in a game. And I think that's what a lot of them teams that's like the Auburns and the teams that's just right there. You just like, you a player two plays away. And that stems from, like, dog, you got to get back.
Yeah, but I'm mad, Maul. I'm mad at another group. I'm mad at the group that is winning and switch it up because they afraid to win the way they was winning.
Mm.
You said it. Prevent defense.
Bruh.
Only thing it prevents is winning.
That's all I've ever seen it do,
bruh. I'm talking about, trust me, because I've been a lifelong Lions fan.
Yes. We live in the
bruh, I'm saying, think about it. Team might have 10 points the whole game.
Bruh.
You score, go up a touchdown, 2 minutes to go. The team may move the ball the whole game. All of a sudden, because you're scared they're going to score. So you stop blitzing. You stop pressuring the quarterback.
Lose
you
that way.
Sit back.
Lose that way.
And I'm fine with that.
Lose the way you've been winning. I'm just being real. And so what my boy missed with the mentality part is.
Give us a real life example of that too.
Yeah, which one?
No, what we just talked about though, because you know, I don't want to be theory. Like, what's a real life example of somebody or something where you've seen somebody who was winning and then they switched up when it got tight and start acting a little different?
Sure, well, I ain't going to lie. For me, it was graduating the first time. Mm. And my mentor, my pastor, Pastor Doggett, he came up to me, bro, it was so crazy. He was just like, yo, you scared to win. Mm. You scared. He's like, you're not stupid. You're not dumb. You did all of this. You passed all these classes. Mm-hmm. You did all of this. All you got to do now is the exit stuff. Why you tripping on the exit stuff? Like, you went back. Mm. All them years you didn't go. You came back. You did everything. Yeah. Now you got to just take an exit exam.
Yep.
You already know all the information and just wrap this thing up. Mm. Like, it ain't even like a schoolwork. Y'all know what I'm talking about. You know at the end when you finish in school, like, all that little stuff you got to do to, like, graduate, to get over the top. And he came to me and was like, yo, you scared. Like, he's like, yo, it's incredible.
Yeah.
You scared. I'm like, scared? Scared of what? I ain't scared of nothing. He's like, no. No, you ain't fooling me. You scared to succeed. Mm-hmm. You've been a high school dropout so long. Mm. You've not succeeded academically your whole life. And you about to cross the threshold. I see it in you. You scared. I said, scared of what? He said, you scared to finish at Oakwood and do whatever's next. Mm. He said, because you know when you finish here, you got to go. Mm. He was like, you already know. He said, me and you both know. Michigan State been coming after you for years. You got to pack your stuff up and go. You scared to start all over again. You got to start over from the bottom. You got to start over from the bottom.
Mm.
You mastered this. You got to go. Yeah. You got to leave here. You got to pack up all your stuff and get out of here and start off as a scrub. Like, you got to go somewhere. Wow. Nobody know you. You got to start from the back. They don't know ET like that. They don't know you got to go and start all up from scratch. But if you go and start off from scratch, you're going to take it to a level that here you can't take it to because we maxed out. We're college. And I didn't know the difference between a university and a college at that time. Mm-hmm. He's like, you maxed out here. You about to go there. And I was just like, wow, you lying. But I knew he wasn't lying. But I never really, as Carl said, wanted to be honest about the fear of, like, yo, what is it going to be like to be rich? Like, what is it going to be like to really be at the top of my game and come outside of Adventism and come outside of Huntsville and, like, going, you know what I'm saying? Like, what is that going to really feel like? Masters, I got to study. I got to whatever. Like, I'm going to go there and people going to see I'm dumb and I'm not comfortable with being dumb. I still care about my image and I want people to think I'm, like, I want people to know where I'm great at, but I don't want people to know where I'm, I'm not great at. And he was telling the truth. And I came here like, man, living in a house to living in
You started all the way over.
Yeah, what is that
Kellogg
called?
Apartment.
You're talking about the apartments?
No. The what's the hotel called? Kellogg Center, right?
Yeah, Kellogg Center.
I thought you were talking about when you lived out there.
Yeah, Kellogg Center was first.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm talking about, I started from the bottom. You know what I'm saying? But that was it for me. So I started playing scared. I stopped being as aggressive as I was before because it was like, okay, I got the school thing, but the paperwork. To this day, I told the Lord yesterday, I was like, God, if you just give me one, like if you tell me I could pay for it with a charge card and I hit the scan, boy, and like I got all my stuff automated and I hit it, is there? Once you tell me you can't hit that, you got to mail it.
Oh, I'm out.
Bruh.
That's how I be doing all of them tickets I be getting on your whip.
Bruh,
that's why I'm paying.
I can pay online.
Don't let me forget. I got your registration.
Okay, good.
Okay. But that's it. That's a real live example of me
self-sabotaging down the stretch. But I think also as you get back to the mentality, it's a reason, and we talk about it, you know, all the time. How you do anything is how you do everything. And it's like when you compartmentalize so much, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's important why I'm all talking about these five pillars and bringing energy to every part of your life because, again, bro, something about when you go in chill mode, the muscle memory behind that. So it's no coincidence when you hear Jordan, they like, bro, after practice, my man just, him and Rip had to shoot. Yeah. But, like, they holding up the team bust.
Yeah.
Like, that ain't nothing. Like, you got to understand something.
And you sitting on the bus pissed.
You sitting on the bus pissed. No. Listen, though. Think about, like, it's always cute when we hear it, but like really think about the mentality of you holding up the bus, everybody ready to go, but you in the gym shooting with Rip because you want to prove to him that you got a better mid-range. Now, mind you, Rip is an incredible mid-range shooter, but you sitting in there, the camera's not on you.
The camera not on you.
I'm just saying. The mentality.
Go Patreon from here.
Yeah.
The camera not on you. No, stay right there.
That's what I'm saying.
The camera not on you. Go ahead.
Nobody knows that this is all we getting this all secondhand years later.
Yeah, the camera's not on you.
No, ain't no camera. This is before cell phone cameras probably like that anyway.
Wow.
So you, this is who you are.
It's who you are.
Wow.
This is who you are.
How many of us would stop doing what we're doing if it wasn't on camera?
Bruh. Oh, my God. Bruh, let me tell you something. I see bruhs all the time. Bruh is whack is all get out. As soon as you pop the camera on, as soon as I'm in front of other people, I treat my wife a certain way.
Ooh.
As soon as everybody looking at me, yes,
getting
dear.
Serious. Bro,
you want me to get you something to drink, boy?
Ooh.
You ain't never asked her to get her nothing to drink at the crib.
Never.
Soon as you in front of everybody else,
because we're at the end of the year. So this is the one that gets me every year. Matter of fact, I'm only gonna work out one time a day now. I'm not going to the gym.
Yeah.
From January to really almost March.
You ain't even going.
I don't want to be in there with them people, dog.
With the camera.
Whenever you post
the camera worker.
Right, when you're showing your workout, that means that you really ain't about it.
Wow.
If I showed how much I work out.
That'd be another job.
Right, that'd be a whole nother job. I'm not even joking.
Yeah. So I'm not doing it for the camera.
You're doing it for the camera, dog. So no, you just make that
a whole nother job for E2.
No, it'd be a documentary for me. It'd be a documentary. Them jokers are had time to catch on.
Oh, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, listen.
I got to go.
I know you got to go.
This is my baby calling. She don't know.
Hold on. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Get that more. While I get this real quick.
Yeah.
Hold on. I'm going to just show you the mentality.
We gotta go, Carl. I got a text.
I got you. I just while you're talking, I just watched a movie this weekend, dude, that blew my mind. You're a track person, so you'll understand. This girl was competing for state championships. Just a movie.
Yeah.
But it was deep.
Yeah.
The person that she was running against had an 800. She was 4 seconds faster than 800. That's a lot of time.
Yeah.
In an 800.
Absolutely.
What the coach did, and this girl would just rip around the track. Yeah. I'm talking about race is over. 4 seconds ahead of everybody else. So this one coach is training to get her athlete ready for it. What she did with her, so they're running in regional. So she trained her, first of all, watch this. She trained her, you talk about staying consistent. Mm. She trained her to run even splits for the first 600 and then increase
on the
last 200.
Mm.
Think about that. She trained her athlete that way.
Yeah.
While other chick is just going for the fastest time every time. She's just going. So they're training. So they ran in regionals. You talk about, you said strategy earlier. In regionals, the coach told her, here's what I want you to do. I want you to run with her for 600 and then fall off. And everybody's looking. I'm talking parents pissed. Everybody pissed. Like, yo, you could have just beat her this regional. She's like, I need you to qualify. Mm. The goal is to beat her in state.
Right.
Not to beat her in the regionals. Bro, they ran. And the coach said, I'm going to get two things to happen this year. This is the top of the year. She's like, I'm going to get you to run faster. I'm going to get her to run slower. Like, how you going to get another athlete to run slower? Bruh, that one race that she did, you understand where I'm going? That one race that she did,
that's
her whole coaching staff, everybody watching, like, oh my God, that girl is right with you for 600 meters. Let's adjust. And what you do is, watch this, she winning everybody by 4 seconds. Let's adjust, and you're going to keep up with her, and then you're going to blur out the last 200 because we know you're faster.
Yeah.
But you never trained like that.
Mm.
You trained to go out, and the coach had already watched her times and realized, oh, she goes fast. She gets out faster, and she tries to maintain.
So
but every 100, she slows down a little bit.
Yeah.
Bruh, it was in the math, Maul. It was in the numbers. Yeah. So she beat her on the paper.
Yeah.
Here's the training. So I'm going to have you run this way, and exactly as the coach said, this is what happened. First 600, she set the pace. Homegirl staying right with her pace, so she off her game.
Yep.
Last 200, homegirl knows how to accelerate. So I'm talking about, chick fell out.
Mm.
Way fast, 4 seconds faster. See, bro, thinking track, bro, four seconds is a lifetime.
Yeah.
But again, back to your training, your mentality. Her coach had her training nonstop, rain, snow, whatever. It's like, yo, track meets happen in this weather. When everybody else stopping, you're training. And the homegirl was just like, all right, you the coach, I'm going to follow. But it just shows you when you get that mentality, bro, the results are going to show.
Yeah, again,
regardless.
Like I said, Maul, I want to go in the other direction and just challenge those of you who are winning and who stop and do something different.
Yeah.
You are winning.
You winning.
You are winning. So it's
that's
like,
a whole
stop.
Other thing, though. Yeah. People don't know when they winning and when they not winning. I'm just being real.
Well, the Bears
I told
winning.
You.
I hear
bro,
you.
Bro, I'm a coach.
And the Bears knew that.
I'm a coach. Yeah. I'm a coach. Listen to what I'm telling you. I'm a coach. People would get on my call every Monday or whatever, whenever I got my calls, and Carl, they'll be like this. Well, yeah, I just want to know. I need to make some adjustments to my speaking and da-da-da. I say, what you doing? Say, yeah, well, I spoke here, and I made this money. I made that money. I said, okay, was that more or less than you made last month? More. Was that more? You've done more this year than you did last year. Okay, cool. It's working. What are we talking about?
Right.
Like switching up.
But listen, when you're looking at other people, now you go, I'm not winning.
Yeah.
So to your point, E, I feel you, but it's people who switch up because they don't know they're winning.
Yeah, and there are people who switch up because they think they're winning.
Right, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because you're comparing yourself.
Absolutely.
And you think
But that's what I'm saying. So if my progress, listen, slow progress be no progress.
Absolutely.
Come on.
And if you can, again, we talked about them little wins. If you can get those little wins, even if it don't look like somebody else's, as long as you're still going forward. I had to tell Ashana. She was like, oh, I'm discouraged. I had a plateau. I ain't losing no weight. I said, you're down 100 pounds in a year. How you not losing no weight? like okay, or are we looking at this day by day?
Yeah, no.
Are we looking at if we're looking at it day by day, it's going, you know,
you're watching other people.
It could be water. I'm sorry, I know you gotta go.
No, hey, I'm saying you watching other people.
But hold on, I got a gift for E. Uh-oh. So just because we're talking about the mentality.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Now you know I can't plan this.
Yeah.
Because we're talking about this. I ain't know this is what we're gonna talk about. I had this ready for you. Yeah. I thought I was gonna have it. I ordered it for you to bring it out to you for Thanksgiving.
But it didn't come.
It didn't come. But I got home, it was there. So I was like, I bet I'm going to the pod.
Yeah.
But just so you know, I'm not playing. I know the mentality. I had me and Candace went ahead and whipped up something for you.
Oh.
Yeah, go ahead, open it up. Come on. Come on.
Mentality.
Come on.
Wow.
I already know what the mentality is.
I thought it was something else. Wow. I thought it was something else. I thought that joke
Come on.
Was something else.
Show the camera.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, he ain't gonna never wear another shirt.
Come on.
Ooh.
Come on. That's the mentality. I ain't even seen it yet. I just.
Ooh.
Yeah. You know
I'm
what I'm saying?
About to joke
home. Hold on. Let me see. I ain't seen it yet. I gotta send Candace.
I'm going to the shower. With that. Come on. I'll hold it. Wow.
Oh, yeah. Go. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
That's it right there.
How Tracy did it.
Yeah. Huh?
I said, how my sister Tracy get it?
Oh, yeah, she just fixing the wedding. That's the only wedding joint we had. You know what I'm saying?
All right, we got to get out of here. Which camera? Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, that's it.
You know what I'm saying?
That's it.
Hey, me and Candace seen it. We was like, why that look like something evil wear with Didi?
I said,
they were showing couples with it.
Hey, so. But hey, let me say this, though.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm still listening. No, at the end of the game, I don't know if y'all remember when they interviewed Nick Saban.
I ain't see it.
After I was crying, I listened to Nick Saban, though, and they were just like, wow, coach, like, man, you know, what was your mentality? What did you feel when he threw the ball in the end zone and got? He said, well, we practice this all the time. Mm-hmm. He said it went just like we practice it.
That's it. Practice this all the time.
It went just like we practice it, bro.
Wow.
At
the back of the end zone.
At the back, he said, bro, he wasn't even smiling or nothing. He literally just looked and was like, this is what we do every day. This is what we expect. We expected these results
mentality.
Because this is what we do up there.
I need to have a call with him, man. Hey, I'm sure it's rough on campus.
Yeah.
No.
It's tough. You think I'm playing?
Yeah, no. It's different. Yeah, it's different. Man, that's deep. And again, to your point, like I said, when people don't, you know, when people switch up or they not winning, it's crazy or they think they not winning.
Yeah.
And it's crazy. Like, how do you judge for yourself, I guess, and now that we ain't got them here, we could just talk. You know what I'm saying? Get them out of here so we got more mic time. But how do you judge progress? Because I think people do struggle with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially the hardest thing, we talked about it before, the hardest thing in the world to do is evaluate yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You could evaluate somebody else easy. You like, oh, they not doing this. But when it comes to your own self, it's so hard to evaluate. What you forget? Keys. Phone, wallet,
keys, wallet, everything.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, he's about to start running. Hey, he got that shirt, though.
Hey, did you find the other keys?
I told you. Once I told you, Dee's only thing was make sure nobody leave with
you. Yeah.
When you left, remember when me and you watched the game? I sat right there on the bed and never looked in the bed.
Oh, you had them the whole time?
Yeah, it was right there on my bed.
On the bed.
Yeah, remember we went to watch the Lions game?
Yeah.
In the room, or was it Michigan State? It was something. But I sat it right there, never checked the bed.
Oh, you got to hit the group text. We was up in arms trying to figure that out. Yeah, hit the group text and get the price report.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? He had lost his keys, bro.
To the house?
No, to the Escalade out there, bro. And we had one set, and I had that set. And between me and Toby, we had one set. And then he was like, I think, check y'all pockets. And so, you know, so it was turning the house upside down. But he had it. So anyway. But no, judging progress. You know what I'm saying? And judging, like, all right, is this working? Even as you take on new stuff. So, for instance, you as a speaker, this is new stuff for you. I don't want to go back and do real estate and stuff like that that you already mastered. Even for speaking, how were you judging your progress?
I thought you was going to say as far as working out.
No.
As far as.
Because I wanted to give you something that you ain't been doing that long so people can relate it to something. Because it's hard. Like, think about it, y'all. Maul never spoke in his life. And I taught Maul the game, showed him how to speak, gave him some principles. But you still had to go in and start working at it. How are you judging if it's working and you're getting better?
Yeah, I think it was just more so like little things, right? So I wasn't judging if I'm getting better overall.
Yeah.
I think that we kept implementing like new pieces to the keynote.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I think it's so many. So within the speaking, within the speech, there's so many different wins that takes place in there. Meaning, like, you used to tell me, like, you know, as far as, like, being funny, right? Yep. Having a part, that's have your whole keynote where you're just all serious. Yep. Being able to say a joke and then be able to hit the joke when you're supposed to hit it. That, for me, was a win. So when I got up there and do my keynote, I wasn't thinking about the whole overall part. I was thinking about the one thing that we worked on and the one thing that I needed to implement and hit that. But
so
then
are you
once
able to
judge it
yourself, though? That's the thing I'm saying. Most people don't have... Like, and again, I'm trying, this isn't, you know, a direct
I think it's
parallel,
three parts.
But most people don't have an audience to give them feedback on their daily life, right?
Yeah.
So you have to be able to give that speech essentially in an empty room and be like, am I getting better? That's different. You know what I'm saying? Some people may not even have a coach to be like, hey, you need to fix this.
Yeah.
So how in this case, if you're going through your daily life, how are you evaluating yourself and saying, am I winning or not? Because if I don't make more money, because if I don't feel better, if I'm not healthier, like how are you evaluating that on a day-to-day without the accountability, maybe, say, that we got.
And I think that's sometimes for a person that don't have the accountability like we might have, right? They don't have a coach. They don't have somebody to say, hey, bro, you didn't do good or you
did
good.
Right.
I think it's just, for me, I found strength and weakness. I found me winning just by getting up every day and doing my pillars.
Mm-hmm.
Just first off, did I get up today and did I spend time with God? Mm-hmm. Did I get up today and did I spend time with my family? Did I get up today and work out? I think the next level is in that workout, like, did I get up and work out and lose whatever pounds? Mm-hmm. But just show up. And I think that was the main thing for me as far as winning, just to show up and do something consistently every single day.
Yeah.
And I think that's what that person don't have that accountability. I was like, are you even doing it as consistently?
Yep.
Because I don't care what kind of workout you do, if you just do something every single day, right? Level one, just do something every single day, you're going to see some type of results. Now you can get to the next level. All right. I've been working out for 3-4 months. I've been losing weight. But if I hit a trainer, maybe I'll lose a little bit more weight. Maybe I can strengthen. So then I think that's the next level. But I think for first part, show up, dog.
Yeah,
show
and
up.
I think if you can get momentum and showing up, I think people get frustrated when you don't see results because you're not sure what it's supposed to look like, right? Like, you start a business. Like, I tell people, like, for real, for us, the last thing to come was the money.
Yeah.
Like, bro, we was in airports, people was like, E.T., and we still wasn't making no bread. So, again, if you judge it strictly financial, then you might be, you know what I'm saying?
I was about to ask you that, though. Just because you're not making money yet, does that mean that something is not taking place?
That's what I'm saying. And that's the thing I think that people get frustrated by is, depending on what metric you're using, if it doesn't look like it's working, right? Like, you're going, if I go to the gym for 2 weeks, I'm working out, I'm eating salad every day, I look at the scale, it ain't move, I'm out. Like, I could have just been eating Twinkies this whole... You see what I'm saying? That's the mentality that people have. And I think that's why people end up stopping, or why they end up changing up the game, is because they don't see themselves as winning.
Yeah.
If they can't... If I don't go work out, run over to the gym today, come back and get on the scale and see 5 pounds lost, I feel like I ain't did nothing. And now I start to get frustrated. So what happens is, Korshawn, does this make sense? You get frustrated and you go, well, it ain't working no way. Right?
But that's what I'm saying. Don't get frustrated in the scale. Your mindset should be in the showing up. You don't worry about the scale. Don't worry about the income.
Right.
I mean, dog, just think about it. How long have I done? I was a speaker for how long before I started to, you know what I'm saying, probably make money? Or people do, I'm talking about, like, even business-wise. Some people in real estate. You know, when I first started out in real estate, I had a small win. I was making $3,000, but I wasn't making $3 million.
Yeah.
But if I would have gave up at that point just because I was only making the $3,000, right. I would be doing a skyscraper today.
Right, right, right.
So I'm saying, so just because, though, it don't look the way you think it should look. Who said it should look that way? Like, who told you you're supposed to get instant Correct. Success?
And I think that's the part, man, that if you could help people really find out what that is and how to, like, but that's a good point. Showing up. Show up to work out. Show up for your family. Show up for your faith. Show up, you know what I mean? Like, and then you allow things to happen when you show up. But I think, man, that's the thing is, like you said, there's going to be so many people in the gym in January, February, bro. What happened? Soon as life hit.
But let me tell you something.
Soon as life hit, they out.
Let me tell you something. I was just talking, me and Camille was talking about this. We was just talking about and somebody going into 2024, you know, this is for you. Showing up, dog, it has changed my life. I mean, I could literally write a book on just showing up.
Mm.
If you just think about it.
Yep.
When you go down the line, like if I wouldn't have never showed up to the first conference ever with ETA,
yep.
Who's to say that I would even be in this position right now?
Mm-hmm.
Right? It wasn't any income coming from it. I wasn't getting paid. You know, it was just literally me showing up to a personal development conference in Hartford, Connecticut.
Yep.
Someplace that most people would have probably said, no, I'm not going to go to that.
Yep.
If I would have never showed up, even when you invited me to come, who's to say that me and you would have connected to, like the way we did?
Right.
And then when you came to Chicago, E and Didi, remember y'all came to Chicago? Yep. It was just on the flim. And you kind of was like, hey, if you can make it, you can make it. It'd be cool. But we about to go out to E. We're going to, E got to speak in it. If I didn't show up,
yep.
Who's to say that we would be in this position? I probably would have never went on the podcast and did episode 105. Pastor Hannah just had me show up at the church and speak. I could have found a reason why, you know, oh, Pastor, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I just showed up not expecting anything.
Yep.
But because of that, boom, somebody from the news station called me. Hey, Jamal, we heard you speak at the church. We want to interview you. Somebody else from the city. Hey, Jamal, we heard what you're doing. We would love for you to come in and showing up. You never know what's on the other side of that door, bro. You never know. And it's the times, I remember it's times in my life where I made myself show up, right? Where I'm trying to make something happen and nothing came from it. But it's been other times when I'm getting the least amount of return. Well, there's not even a return connected to it.
Yep.
But you show up and the most unbelievable things happen in your life. And I think a lot of people, man, you probably missed out on hundreds of blessings.
Mm.
Because you didn't show up. Why? You didn't show up because you didn't see the monetary value in it.
Yep.
But there's an intrinsic value that will change your life. And money is always, money is the smallest part when you think about it. And so, but I think a lot of people pass up on that, bro. They pass up because they don't show up.
We always call that miracle territory.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He always be like, dog, we got to put ourselves in miracle territory. I don't know what that is.
Yep.
And it don't mean that every time we go somewhere or show up or do something, some major thing about to happen, but we increase our odds. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, 100%. Mo, you got a training this weekend, right?
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
Talk to the people. This, it's what, 2 days? This come out Thursday. So, you got my...
it's One Property Away.
Okay, One Property Away.
Yeah, almost, yep.
Where can they still sign up?
Yeah. You go to OnePropertyAwaySummit.com. OnePropertyAwaySummit.com. We actually got the summit...
Starts on...
On December the 4th.
Okay.
Yep, December the 4th to the 7th. We going in. 5 days, bro. We going
five
in.
Days,
5 days. We covering fix and flip. We covering wholesaling. We covering buy and hold. And we're making it personal. This is just not some terminology that you're going to get on YouTube. This is like personal.
Yep.
Like I tell people all the time, like you one property away from having whatever it is in life you want to have. And we've been training people to actually like people that want to start businesses. But because they never had experience in business, the bank never gave them a business loan. So now we're showing them that your business is in the bricks. We're showing people how.
Yep.
And then, man, even in this kind of economy, people are saying like, hey, man, the real estate market is not good. The economy is not good. Interest rates are high. And I'm telling people, bro, when interest rates are high, that means that properties are lower, right? They're cheaper, right? When our interest rates were low, everybody was buying properties.
Right.
So yeah, your interest rate is low, but now you got about 20 people bidding on the same property.
Right, right.
Right now, there's not a lot of people bidding on the property. So look, marry the property, date the interest rate, all right? Mm. Date the interest rate, meaning that secure the property right now. Secure the property, right? And you're going to get it $50,000, $100,000 cheaper because of supply and demand. The supply is great, but the demand is low. So now you can negotiate your way down.
Yep.
So knock off 50 off the top. But when the interest rates are lower, everybody's buying and the supply is low, but the demand is great.
Mm-hmm.
So now you're bidding $50,000 to $100,000 more.
Yep.
So it's like, look, man, get the property at a cheaper price And then as soon as the interest rates go down, which they will, refinance, and then get a lower interest rate. So, yeah, bro. So that's what we teach you, man. OnePropertyAwaySummit.com.
Yep. Make sure y'all sign up this weekend. 5 days straight.
5 days straight.
5 days straight.
And you got me all 5 days. This ain't no, I ain't got, you know, you got Jamal the whole time.
Yeah. No, get your questions answered. And I believe it's, I think the regular price is what, like $297 or something?
So you got three different. You got you got the Platinum, which is $497.
Yep.
You got the VIP, which is $297.
Yep.
And then you have the General Admission, which is $97.
Come on, bro. I mean, y'all better get in there, man. This is an absolute steal right around the holidays, man. Get this information like we talked about. You don't want to be the dude or the young lady trying to get ready when you absolutely need it. Get yourself ready now. Start getting the information now. Get in the community that also believes in the information and knows how to apply it, man, and take your family, take your life to the next level. It's changed. Obviously, Carl, E, and I, the information is taking our family to a whole nother level. So make sure y'all check that out, OnePropertyAwaySummit.com. That's this weekend that gets started. So we look forward to seeing y'all there. As for me and mine, we ain't got nothing going on. We just chilling. So, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate y'all, man. Thanks, Korshawn. We out of here. We love you. We'll see you next week.
Let's go.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to this show, please, I'm begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.